Hey everybody, Greg Davies here. In this video I'm going to show you how to float div tags and place elements side by side. By default, elements follow each other on the web page in the same exact order as in the code itself. But what if I want to place elements next to each other? Well, let me show you. I'm going to create two div tags here and I'll show you how to place them side by side. I go to code view and I type in a div star tag right here. I'm using an inline style now, so I can style my div tag here in the code. And I'm gonna float my div tag. That's how you can place elements side by side, by floating them. So I type in float left, close it off. Hit my spacebar. Now if you're doing this in your Dreamweaver CSS dialog box, you'll find float inside of the box category. Okay, your element must have a width value applied to it if you want to float it. So I type in width. Let's say 200 pixels. Close it off. Hit my spacebar. And I also type in height. Let's say 200 pixels, close it off, hit my spacebar, and I type in margin, top, let's say 20 pixels, right, 10 pixels, bottom, 20 pixels, and left, 0, close it off. It goes in a clockwise motion, starting from the top. Okay, I close my div star tag and I type in some text here so it has some content inside of it, like a paragraph tag and float 1, and I close my paragraph tag. And I need a div end tag as well. Okay, I go to design view. And with the floats, every other element underneath it, unless I clear the float, is going to try to move to the side of that particular element. If you want to wrap around an image with text, for example, this is what you need to do. But now I don't want my text to move to the side of my div tag. So I'm going to clear the float. I go back to the code. And under my floating element, I type in and I close it off. Okay, I go back to design view. And because I've cleared the float, my text no longer tries to move to the side of my div tag. Okay, I go back to the code. I copy my div tag. And paste it in again right under it. Okay, I paste it in again. I need three of them just so that you really understand how they work. And this comes first in the code, this comes second in the code, and this comes third in the code, just so that you see where they are on the page. And I clear the float under my last floating element. I go to design view, and here they are. My div tags are lining up next to each other. I float them left. So the first one in the code is on the very left and the following floated elements are lining up next to it on the right. If you float them right, the first element in the code will be on the right and the following floated elements will line up next to it on the left. Floating is the basis for creating complex web pages, so you really need to understand it, but as you could see, it's not that difficult at all. And of course, you can style these elements any way you want. You can give them a border, a background color, or background image, whatever you want. I'm not gonna do it now. You already know how to do it from my previous videos. If you go through all of my videos, you'll become a professional web designer pretty fast. So go to my website, easywebdesignsystem.com, and check out all of my videos. Okay, I end this video now. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.